Running is undergoing a boom at the moment. Fueled by the recession and New Year's resolutions, more people are hitting the road. So whether you're on the path to fitness or chasing down a personal best, the Garmin Forerunner 410 will help you along the way. The 410 is a flagship watch of the Forerunner fleet, and while it's little on the large side, it's about the size of a Casio G-Shock Classic, and slightly lighter with an ergonomic design, which means that using it on the move is as simple as putting one foot in front of the other. The 1.06-inch screen is clear, with excellent viewing angles and a bright backlight, and the design of the watch means the buttons won't dig into your wrist while you put in the miles. Garmin upgraded the bezel control of the predecessor to be more sensitive, and touching different areas of the bezel brings up a different selection of menus, cutting down the navigation time. If you just want to start training, it's one touch away before you're locked onto a satellite in less than a minute and you're ready to start the timer. You can use the bezel to scroll clockwise or anti-clockwise to move up and down through the menus, although we found it a little too touch sensitive while running in the rain, where a wet sleeve would activate the menu, or not enough, for instance, while running wearing gloves. This isn't a major problem, as the controls can be locked during exercise, and the watch keeps tracking your run while you scroll through the menus, but if you're training for a marathon in all weather and constantly checking your stats, it's more of an issue. The display is customizable, and users can choose from 35 sets of data, from mile pace and altitude to time lapsed, to display on up to 3 screens. After the run, you can review your basic stats on the watch or on the Garmin Connect service. This is a wealth of information and analysis which tracks all the detail from your run, including heart rate, if you're wearing the optional heart rate monitor accessory. Connect also lets you share your run page with your friends, although we did find some errors in the reporting, when during a half marathon we were clocked on the final mile at over 1,000 miles per hour. This didn't make a difference to the overall average time, and Garmin will no doubt improve this analysis soon. Uploading a run to the website, however, worked every time, while the watch synced wirelessly via the provided Ant Plus USB dongle. Other features include the ability to save a location, so you can find your way back to your car, or race against a virtual partner on your logged routes. Battery life is about 2 weeks in normal watch mode, and Garmin claims 8 hours in training mode. In practical terms, we charged it fully in 2 hours over the weekend, wore it all week, in which we tracked 2 10K runs and a half marathon, and by the following Wednesday it was still 26% full. There is a small matter of price, which at £300 for the heart rate monitor version or £270 without is a little steep during a recession. For us, it just doesn't add enough whistles and bells onto those included in its predecessor, the Forerunner 405CX, which can be had for £70 less. But if you want a sports watch that does it all, it's a great piece of kit and a valuable training partner to help you get the most out of your workouts.